So you've been looking for ways to make your videos more engaging. I've got you covered. Ben, you should seriously stop. I'll take it from here. Go on. Anybody else relieved that part of the video is over? A simple but effective way you can make your videos more engaging is by using graphics and slides. Today, I'm going to show you a free and easy to use tool to help you make beautiful graphics for your videos, even if you're not an expert. Let's get into it. Hello creators, I'm Ben Tolson from Podia, where we empower creators like you to make a living doing what you love. There are lots of free tools for creating graphics for your videos, but today we're going to focus on one of my favorites called Canva. Canva is a web-based design tool that is easy to use, but very powerful. As I walk you through how to use Canva to make graphics for your videos, I'll also share some basic design principles that will serve you no matter what program you're using. Later in this video, I'm going to show you how to make a new document from scratch. But before we do that, we're going to take a look at Canva's templates. You might find a template set that works with your branding or that you could make small adjustments to that would save you tons of time. After you click on the templates link on the left, you'll look under Browse by Categories and choose Presentation. These templates already have the correct dimensions, and you can see that there are tons of different options available. They've also been made with design principles in mind, so they already look great right out of the box. As an example, let's say we're making a course about turning your hand lettering into physical products, and we want a graphic at the beginning of the course series that gives an overview of what will be covered in the lessons. I'm going to go ahead and use this one. Now I'm going to find the panel that matches the presentation style I'm going for. In this case, I want to present the info as a list with some basic info, so let's go with this one. Now all I have to do is fill in the information. Each element of the design is editable with different options for each type of object. I want to edit the text, so I'm going to double click on the text I want to change and type in my copy. Now we're done, so we can click on the download button, click file type and select the format we'd like to use. PNG is best for how we plan to use it. Click the select pages dropdown and select the specific page we'd like to download. You'll notice it wants to charge us for use of a graphic. That's because we're using the free version of Canva. If we click on the dropdown, we can see which graphic they want to charge us for and then either choose to use it, replace it with something else, or simply delete it. Then we can click the download button and choose where we'd like to save our graphic. If you want to make a graphic from scratch, you may want to add your brand colors first. To do this, click on the brand kit link on the left and then choose your brand colors. Click the Create a Design button on the left and choose Presentation. This will give you a blank page to work from in the right dimensions. The first thing we're going to do is set our background. There are two ways you can do this. The first way is to click on the Background button on the left. You'll see several choices of patterns and gradients. If you don't see your brand color but see a pattern or gradient you like, click on it and see if it has options to adjust the colors. Another way you can set your background is to click the Elements button and use a solid shape. You can stretch the shape across the entire background and then choose your color. Make sure to use a color that fits your brand and also allows your text to be easy to read. If your background color is darker, you'll want to go with lighter text and vice versa. Now we're going to set our graphic elements. Graphic elements can add visual interest to your design and can also highlight your brand. If you already have a logo or other graphic elements saved on your computer, you can click the Uploads icon and then find and upload your graphics. If you don't have any graphic elements, you can still add visual interest by clicking on the Elements icon and choosing lines or shapes. You want to keep it simple, but it can still go a long way toward making your graphics more interesting. If there are elements you would use for every slide, go ahead and make duplicates so you don't have to repeat the work you've done so far. You can do this easily by clicking the copy page icon just above your design. Now it's time to add your text. Like the templates I showed you earlier, there are some pre-made text arrangements that are already well designed and may work for your purposes. Click on the text icon on the left to see the different options. If you like a specific arrangement but not the font, you can always change the font after you add it to your design. If you'd like to create your own text from scratch, you can simply add heading, subheading, or body text to your design. There are a few things you'll want to keep in mind while adding text. Make sure the text is easy to read. This means the font is legible and the colors of the text contrast well against the background. Use hierarchy in your text to help your viewer have a better understanding of the content. Use additional formatting like bolding, italics, or bullets to make your content even more clear. The last thing we're going to talk about is adding images. In the Photos tab, there are many options for free images you can use in your design. If you can't find what you're looking for in Canva, you can always go to a royalty-free image site like Unsplash.com or Pixabay.com, save your image, and then upload your image to Canva in the Upload tab. Once you've found an image you like, just double-click on it and it'll automatically be added to your design, or you can click on it and drag it over. You can resize your image by clicking and dragging the transform points, or you can crop your image by holding down the Shift key as you drag the transform points. A couple more things to remember. You can change the layering of objects by selecting an object and then clicking on Position in the upper right hand of your screen. You can move objects backwards or forwards depending on how you'd like your elements to display. For all of your design elements, another important design principle to keep in mind is spacing. You want to allow for a bit of margin around each of the elements, and in most cases, you want to try to center objects within the space they occupy. You want to keep this process relatively simple. Don't try to get too involved or do too much before you feel comfortable. Just a little bit of work can go a long way toward making your information easier to comprehend and your course videos more engaging. Are there other free design tools that you've used to make graphics for your online course videos? Tell us about them in the comments below. If you found this video useful and you want more content like this, click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you'll be sure not to miss any of our future videos. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.